Brutal attackers broke her neck. That was more than two decades ago. Now her recent death changes everything, including her case.
This is News 8 Now in high definition.
The year 1984, Chrissy Blakely was just 20 years old.
Beautiful and vibrant, then attacked by a violent group of strangers.
Now, 25 years later, she dies, and her attack all those years ago is now a murder investigation. Chris Hawes has this exclusive report.
This is when we took.
It's been 25 years. But ask Ida Blakely about the day she first walked into her daughter's hospital room, and each word is a struggle.
I almost passed out when I saw her.
This was Christina Blakely before the attack. She was juggling college, motherhood, and a new career as a hair model. It all changed at a Fort Worth shopping center.
She was attacked. There was five or six of them.
Her long blonde hair, her family was told, possibly pulled back, snapping her spinal cord. Her would-be killers, strangers, got away.
I never really thought much anymore about who did it and why did they do it or anything, because I had my hands full making sure that she had everything she needed or wanted.
While still a toddler, her son, Ryan, helped her relearn eating by feeding his mother M&Ms one at a time. With therapy, she learned to move her arms slightly.
Her hands were like this, but my mom still was determined to brush her teeth, wash her face.
But over time, Chrissy Blakely's spirit no longer matched her health. Pneumonia, bed sores, and related health problems increasingly kept her in her room, her world.
She has a lot of gifts in here.
Last week, Chrissy went to the hospital for the last time. She died Tuesday following complications from surgery. Ryan allowed himself to realize the full injustice of his mother's life in her final difficult months.
And I remember sitting by her bed and I, you know, would just cry.
The case is now a homicide investigation. The family's final wish for Chrissy Blakely, someone will contact Fort Worth investigators and close the final chapter in her tragic story. In Fort Worth, Chris Hawes, Channel 8 News.